Let's take a minute to get familiar with the overall structure of the Google Ads interface. Understanding the basic layout of what you see when you log in will help you to manage and optimize your account much more efficiently and set you on the road to pay-per-click success. Now, when you first log in, you arrive here, and this is your overview page. Now, when you're first starting out, this section will be blank, but I went ahead and set up a couple of campaigns for a fictional hotel just so you can see how this might appear once you've begun your own advertising. Now, it's on this page that you'll have at-a-glance information that gives you insights into each area of your account. You'll see cards that report on clicks, impressions, your average cost per click, the total cost that you've spent so far, and so on. We can see information on our campaigns, keywords, the searches that are triggering our ads, and so on. Now, each of these sections is interactive. For example, I can select clicks and choose instead click-through rate, and now I can see that metric charted over time. Now, when it comes to time, all of the reporting that you interact with will be controlled by the date picker in the upper right-hand corner. Now, for starters, this is set to all time, but you have the option to quickly choose the last 30 days, this month, the last 7 days, or you can even select a custom date range. Doing so will change the data in the reporting below. Next, you'll find this flyout menu on the left-hand side, and this is controlled by selecting the arrow to minimize and expand it, or you can also trigger it by selecting the hamburger menu in the upper left-hand corner. Now, this panel gives you quick access to all of your campaigns. You can select the drop-down icon to choose if you'd like to look at all campaigns or all campaign groups. You can select the vertical three dots to filter by status. So here you can select all enabled, everything, including those that have been removed, and so on. And then you have the option to sort by selecting the arrow icons. And you can choose if you'd like to sort your campaigns by cost, status, impressions, and so on. And this really helps if you have a lot of campaigns that you're managing. I'm going to go ahead and close the flyout menu. Now, as you navigate around Google Ads, you'll always know where you are by looking at the top of the screen. Here we can see that we're in all campaigns. Now, if I select keywords on the left-hand side, we've moved into our search keywords report. But if you notice, the top of the page still says all campaigns. What this means is that I'm looking at keywords across all of my campaigns. If instead I select into a campaign, and I can do that by choosing campaigns, and then select the campaign that we'd like to drill into, in this case, I'll choose the Land and Hotel Fall Promotion, you'll notice at the top of the screen, it now shows me that I'm within Land and Hotel's Fall Promotion. When I select keywords on the left-hand side of the screen, you'll now notice that we're still inside the Land and Hotel Fall Promotion. So I'm now looking at all search keywords specific to this particular campaign. It's important that you remember where you are so that as you're making changes to, say, your settings, locations, demographics, and so on, you're doing it for the campaign that's selected. Or if you're wanting to make a global change, well, then you're doing it at the all campaigns level. Now, moving to the top right-hand corner of the screen, you'll see several important options. First is search, and when you select search, it brings up a prompt that allows you to search for anything that you're looking for. In this case, let's say I need to find the billing page. I can just type in billing, and I'm gonna see everything that matches that search. Now, you can also bring up search by selecting G and T on your keyboard, and then typing in whatever it is you're looking for. Next to this is our reports icon, and this makes it easy to identify either any predefined reports or any reports that have been built and saved, or simply give you access to the reporting dashboards. To the right of this, we have our tools and settings menu. This is where you'll access essential optimization, planning, measurement, and setup information. To the right of this, we have a billing tab, and this will take you to all of your billing insights. Here you'll be able to see your balance, all the transactions, and manage your payment methods. To the right of the billing icon is the help icon. This allows you to quickly find a quick reference map, identify new features, and even submit support requests. To the right of this is a little bell icon, and when it has a red circle, it indicates that you have new notifications. These often show up as suggestions or announcements that can help you better understand how things are performing in Google Ads. And then in the far top right corner is your account. And when you select that, you can log out, view your settings, or you can even add different Google accounts or switch between users if you have multiple accounts configured. Take the time to explore the interface, as understanding where to find what you need will help you be more efficient when you're creating, maintaining, and optimizing your campaigns.